about this stoush between the RBA and Jim Chalmers. We've just been discussing it on the show. The RBA Governor Michelle Bullock has kept rate hikes on the agenda, despite Jim Chalmers claiming that they were, quote, smashing the economy. Andrew, is it all the RBA's fault, do you think?
Well, of course it's not the RBA's fault. Jim Chalmers needs to go and look in the mirror to see whose fault it is. Now, you know, I've seen Wayne Swan, the 25th president of the ALP, leap to Jim Chalmers' defence. Jim Chalmers used to be his chief of staff, so it shouldn't come as any great surprise that Wayne Swan would be leaping to his defence. But look, it is absolutely fundamentally clear that Jim Chalmers has lost control. He has no idea what he's doing. He's only been in the job 2 years, as some of your commentators were talking about earlier in the program. But what's really concerning, and we've been saying this for a long time now, is that, and Michelle Bullock belled the cat. She's talked constantly about, and again today, about the real problem is inflation. It's inflation which is causing the cost of living crisis in this country. And you look at other countries around the world. New Zealand has reduced its interest rates. The Reserve in the US is likely to reduce interest rates this month, being in September. So other countries, similar economies, are now looking to reduce interest rates. But Michelle Bullock has made very, very clear at the last RBA meeting, she said there was a line ball decision whether to lift interest rates or to keep them as they are. So it's very much on the radar of the Reserve Bank to continue to hiking interest rates if that's what it means to get inflation down. Now, why do we need to get inflation down? Well, you've literally got the RBA with both feet on the brakes of the economy, trying to slow things down. But then you've got the federal Labor government trying to speed things up. You've got the federal Labor government bringing in more than 1 million people into this country over the last 2 years, creating all sorts of housing havoc. The economic settings that have been put in place by this Labor government are working directly against those of the RBA, and that's why inflation is staying so sticky for so long, and that's why the average Australian is now paying $24,000 a year in their mortgage repayments after tax, greater than what they were paying under a coalition government.
As the RBA governor basically warned that it's going to get worse, it's a real problem for this country. Andrew Wallace, great to have you on. Really appreciate your time.